Good morning everyone and welcome back to a brand new video on my channel Shubhra's Vlogs. This time I am going to start a new series in a different country, and this new country is going to be a European country, namely Russia. Yes, I am traveling to the city of St. Petersburg, which is also known as Venice of the North or the northern capital of Russia.
Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to yet another video. Right now I am here at Kolkata airport, that is the Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose airport, in the international section, because I am going to fly to another new country, and this time it's gonna be Russia. So I'm flying to St. Petersburg. My flight is from the Emirates. First I will have my flight to Dubai, that is EK571, and then from Dubai to St. Petersburg, EK175. So it's going to be a long journey, but a very exciting one. I'm really excited to see how this Emirates flight is, and I will share the entire experience with you. So right now let's head over to the gates from where we will be boarding, because all our formalities and everything is completed and we are ready for check-in. So let's take a look around Kolkata airport and then head straight towards our gate.
Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport was very busy and hustling early in the morning. There were so many people who were about to travel to different parts of the country and also different parts of the world. So as I was heading towards my gate, I passed across many duty-free shops and other shops selling different souvenirs and snacks, which are a pretty common sight here at the Kolkata International Airport. There you can see the flight from Kolkata to Paro in Bhutan, Bhutan Airlines, coming towards the Aero Bridge. The flight to Paro was also about to leave. And this is our Emirates flight getting ready for boarding. Meanwhile, I was feeling very, very hungry. So thanks to my mom for preparing these beautiful snacks that I could munch on sitting at the airport. And after that, I went for a quick stroll. This is a very beautiful bridge, and you can see the entire infrastructure of the Kolkata airport is very beautiful, especially the ceiling, which is very reminiscent of Bengali literature and Bengali culture. By the way, those are our captains for the flight. Both of them were foreigners, and I was pretty excited for our flight because this was the first time I was traveling on the Emirates. So I was definitely excited to see what all the hype about Emirates was. And there was our crew, and we were almost ready for boarding.
Alright, so we are ready to board.
And now I am walking through the Aero Bridge towards our flight. Our boarding was on time, on schedule, no delays whatsoever. But our flight was fully packed. So you can see a long queue that was moving very slowly in front of me. And it took me around 10 minutes to complete my boarding, really. So this is the business class of this Emirates flight. Unfortunately, I was not sitting on the business flight, of course. And just behind the business class, this was my seat. I didn't get the window seat this time, but on the aisle, which is pretty okay, normal, no problem. But the seats were definitely really comfortable. Also, our flight had different cameras, so I could take a beautiful pilot's view of the takeoff, and it was absolutely mesmerizing. Looking over the city of Kolkata from high above the sky felt me really nostalgic. Who knows, maybe I was passing over my own house. So yeah, goodbye Kolkata. We'll see you again really, really soon. So the entertainment system on the Emirates flight was equipped with all the latest movies and shows, so definitely you can enjoy your time while on the flight. But what I was really waiting for was the food. And once the food arrived, I was pretty surprised because it had so much to offer. The food was absolutely delicious and also nutritious, so I really enjoyed my meal. And after a while, we were flying over Dubai. You can see the terrain of Dubai. We were about to land. Once again, thanks to the different cameras installed on our flight, I could get a really wonderful view of our landing. Really the view that the pilot gets, so it was pretty exciting and also enjoyable. There you go. So welcome to Dubai International Airport DXB. We actually arrived almost half an hour early and now it was time for us to deboard the plane. Once again, take a look at the beautiful business class seats of the Emirates. This is really high class. Really loved it. So the outside temperature at Dubai was 41 degrees Celsius. That is extremely hot. But luckily, I was just here at the DXB International Airport for 2.5 hours of layover, so I didn't really have the time to go out of the airport to explore anything else. So I was just seated in the transit area. But in a way, that was a boon in disguise because the temperature outside was absolutely unbearable. So welcome to Dubai Airport. This is your first look at the airport. By the way, do I look tired? Well, I guess no, because the journey was pretty comfortable, so not really tired. And in fact, I was really excited for my next flight from Dubai to St. Petersburg. So here you can see the connections written in red. So I just followed those symbols and proceeded towards the connecting flights through Dubai Airport.
Hey everyone, so I have reached Dubai from Kolkata. Now I have a 2.5 hour layover here at the DXB International Airport, and then I have another Emirates flight all the way to St. Petersburg. So stay tuned and keep watching the video to see how this journey goes, the second part where we head over to St. Petersburg. Let's see.
So while I was waiting at the airport for my next flight, I decided to explore the different duty-free shops and the market area here at the Dubai International Airport, which is indeed pretty famous all across the world for really prestigious brands and high quality jewelry and other materials. And I can guarantee that it's absolutely true. The shops here, the products that they were selling at the DXB airport was of course very high quality, and it was really mesmerizing to look at all these shops from outside.
So now I'm here at the Dubai airport I had to go through another security check. It's done now. Now I am heading towards the gate where I will be boarding my next flight to St. Petersburg, and it is B27. So now I am heading towards gate number B27 at the DXB International Airport.
So on my way to gate number B27 for my next flight, I came across many interesting shops, and one of them was this chocolate shop, which had so many interesting chocolates and candies, which honestly I had never seen before in my life. There were many lollipops, many chocolate hampers and other candies, which I would describe as a paradise for kids and chocolate lovers. Of course, at the airport there were many other eateries and cafe options for you to take some refreshments while you are waiting for your flight. And ultimately I reached my gate, that is B27, for my flight to St. Petersburg. Soon enough we were checked in and we were led towards the boarding gate, with a few more minutes remaining until we were officially boarded onto the flight. On this flight, the number of passengers were comparatively less to the flight before, which is pretty understandable because not many people are traveling to St. Petersburg these days. But definitely it was pretty nice to see a lot of Russians here because they were traveling from Dubai to St. Petersburg. Here you can see the person in front of me who was my co-passenger, a really helpful and kind man. So it was wonderful traveling with him on this journey. But this time, luckily, I got the window seat. Once again, the Emirates flight was equipped with the cool ICE entertainment system, and the seats were pretty comfortable and with a lot of legroom. So once again, ready for a very comfortable and pleasant journey, and this time I could enjoy the view outside as well. So soon, right on time, we were ready for takeoff. Although I don't think it was captured in the camera, but I could really spot the Burj Khalifa from my seat, and it was a very mesmerizing view, honestly. Looking at Dubai from high above was pretty interesting, but what excited me more was to look at the beautiful blue sky covered with white clouds. It was as if I am flying over heaven. Soon we came closer to St. Petersburg after a flight time of almost 6 hours. And it was evening time in St. Petersburg. Because of the white nights, sun was still out, and it was amazing to see the sunset from the sky above. Meanwhile, our lunch was served and it was absolutely delicious. Russian cuisine this time, but really, really amazing. After lunch, we decided to take some rest, and the flight was so beautifully lit up, pleasant for sleeping. At almost 8:30 p.m. local time, we were flying over the city of St. Petersburg. You can see the beautiful rivers and oceans out there, and we were definitely ready for landing by now. Once again, this flight was bang on time. There was no delay whatsoever. And we were ready to touch down at the Pulkovo International Airport in St. Petersburg at 8:30 p.m. in Russian time, which was still 15 minutes earlier than scheduled. So you can understand the punctuality of Emirates. It's always bang on time. Welcome to St. Petersburg, Pulkovo International Airport. It's white night's time still here in St. Petersburg, so even at 9 p.m. at night, there's sunlight. It's as if it's evening, and we were headed towards immigration. After finishing off all the formalities, I decided to stay back at the airport because it was midnight and I didn't really want to go outside at night. So I just kept waiting and resting at the airport until the next morning. Early next morning, I decided to leave the airport and book a cab and go towards my apartment here in St. Petersburg, which is located near the Chornaya Ryachka metro station.
So we are finally out here in St. Petersburg, Russia. As you had already seen that I spent the night at the airport because it was safe and also a better option because the prices were also pretty high at night for taxis. So I decided to stay back, wait for the night and now leave early in the morning. It's 5:30 a.m. right now. And now I will book a cab using Yandex Go app and then head over to my apartment. So stay tuned and see how it goes. By the way, take a look at St. Petersburg in early morning.
The early morning in St. Petersburg was absolutely mesmerizing. Although the region here at the Pulkovo airport was extremely cold, almost 9 degrees centigrade in the morning, it was pretty amazing. This is my second time here at St. Petersburg, so I was really familiar with a lot of things. And that led to a hassle-free experience for me. But if you are traveling to St. Petersburg for the first time, you might have some difficulties in understanding, mostly because of the language barrier. So feel free to ask your questions in the comments down below, and I would be happy to help you out with any formalities or any difficulties that might occur during your journey here to St. Petersburg. You can also connect me on my social media platforms or send me an email with your questions. I will be happy to help. Traveling from the airport to my apartment took me around 30 minutes because early in the morning there's no traffic really and the road was pretty clear. So once again, enjoying the beautiful sunrise here in St. Petersburg was absolutely fascinating. The journey was absolutely comfortable, and soon I was near my apartment. St. Petersburg is called the Venice of the North, so you can understand that there would be lots of water bodies and canals all across the city. The vlogs of all the beautiful places in St. Petersburg will be coming out on my channel very soon, So do consider subscribing to my channel and hitting that notification bell so that you stay updated with all the latest videos that will be coming out on my channel. I welcome all of you to St. Petersburg. Let's explore this beautiful and historic city together. So that's it for this video. Very soon I will be back with more videos of St. Petersburg. Stay tuned, and until then, stay happy and stay healthy. I will see you again very soon from St. Petersburg.